Friends, welcome back to my channel. I received this comment from my viewer. If we have some open circuit in secondary side, what will the response of the circuit? Because it is a question from my viewer, I will discuss. We have this power supply. It will receive AC voltage from here, rectify, and this IC here it is using L2269. Current mode SMPS controller, it is like 3842, 384, 344, 45, similar. It will drive the MOSFET, it will switch. When it will start switch, the voltage will build in the output side, output rectifier and capacitor will receive voltage. When the voltage will maintain at specific level, at that time, it will receive feedback signal to maintain the duty cycle. In case it cannot receive feedback, what it will do? It will utilize its maximum duty cycle to find the feedback. It will seek for feedback. It will utilize its maximum duty cycle until the voltage will reach at maximum limit, that at VCC pin from auxiliary winding. When the VCC or VDD will increase than its upper limit, it will go in cutoff state. When it will go in cutoff state, the switching will stop for a while until the voltage will decrease than the threshold. At that time, it will start to switch again. It will again utilize maximum duty cycle, because we have some disconnection in the output side. Either the winding is disconnected, our rectifier is open circuit, anything in feedback circuit, optocoupler is damaged. What is any cause? Track is missing, track broken. When the feedback will not reach at feedback pin, it will not give output. Let's check. If you don't have a good practical experience in power electronics, never try to do any experiment or never try to repair. I will apply AC power at AC input terminals and then we will see practically what happens. This is a working power supply and we can see the lamp turned on and then it is in normal condition now. I have 12.1 volt output. And this time, if we check the voltage at the VCC capacitor, that are 15.5 volt. It is 15.5 volt. And if we check voltage at main DC capacitor, it is 338 volt. Voltage at main DC capacitor 338.5 volt and these are stable. These are not fluctuating. Let's make open circuit. And if the power is applied, never touch any component. Even if the power is removed, until this capacitor is discharged, never touch any component. Still it have 10 volt. So until the capacitor is discharged, never touch any component. We will make open circuit. I will open the bridge rectifier or full wave rectifier whatsoever here. And then we will see the response. Yes, this removed now. This time we disconnected the circuit. Let's connect power. We don't have output voltage here now. Now we will see the condition of this VCC capacitor. The VCC capacitor is fluctuating. And if we check the condition of this capacitor, It is 340 volt and it is fluctuating. Because we don't have any load in the output side, but our IC is switching and it is going in restart mode. So VCC capacitor will fluctuate badly. If we have some high power SMPS at that time, we will also find fluctuation at this capacitor. But if we check the voltage in the output side, we will not find anything. That means we have anything bad here. That is one condition, that we don't find any voltage. But if we have something bad in this network, we will find the voltage here, but we will not find regulation, because this is for regulation. If our rectifier is good, our this circuit is good, and we have something open circuit here, at that time we will not able to find feedback. Let me connect this diode. So if we have fluctuation at VCC capacitor and we have fluctuation at main DC capacitor and we cannot find the output voltage at that time, we need to check this area. Rectifier, we need to check the continuity of the winding, because this time the transformer primary winding is switching and we are taking feedback from the auxiliary voltage. That means primary side is switching, so that the voltage at VCC pin are fluctuating. That means the IC is trying to switch, but it cannot transfer the voltage in the secondary side due to any reason. If there is open circuit, or if this rectifier is short, if there is a short circuit at that time, we will find some millivolts here. And if we have anything open circuit here, for example in feedback, let me open something from the feedback. Okay, I will open this TL431. If anything here is bad, what will happen now? Let's see. We have output voltage. We can see the output voltage are fluctuating. This time, if we have open circuit in this area, we have fluctuation in the output. And we will find the fluctuation at VCC capacitor. And we will find fluctuation here at main DC capacitor, bulk capacitor. So these are the fault conditions. When we see the fault, at that time we must consider the design. What is in the design? How this circuit is working? So at that time we will go pinpoint to the fault. For example, VCC pin is fluctuating, main DC capacitor is fluctuating, and we don't have any output. That means there is some open circuit. If we find some millivolts here, and we have fluctuation in these two components, VCC pin and the main DC capacitor, and we find some millivolt in the output pins, that means there is something short circuit. If we have a huge fluctuation in output, fluctuation here, that means we have problem in feedback circuit. I hope so you enjoyed this video. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have some other experience like that, or if you want to add something, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.